U.S. Air Force F-15E Strike Eagle fighter jet has been loaded up with 5 AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missiles, or JASSMs, for the first time. This was done as part of a proof of concept at Eglin Air Force Base, Florida. The idea was to increase the JASSM load of F-15E Strike Eagle fighter, a part of Project Strike Rodeo. While the jet was not flown, it can be assumed that a flight test with this load will be carried out in the near future. The trial was undertaken by the 85th Test and Evaluation Squadron, TES. Viewers may note, in regular configurations, F-15Es are loaded with 2 JASSMs. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how F-15E Strike Eagle fighter, armed with 5 JASSMs, could enhance the tactical resilience of air-to-ground missions for the U.S. Air Force. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The test is the outcome of a proposal that envisions a fighter formation carrying out air-to-ground strike with a JASSM salvo instead of a single bomber. U.S. Air Force media release stated this would reduce the size and complexity of the strike package, as well as distribute mission risk across the force. It's to be noted that while a bomber needs fighter escorts in most scenarios, a fighter formation will self-escort, as they can also deploy air-to-air weapons if required. Also, bombers like B-52 and B-1B need large bases for operation, while fighters can take off from much smaller, obscure ones, which improves operational flexibility. This is also in sync with the distributed lethality concept of the U.S. military that aims to disperse firepower across different platforms. In its conventional layout, the F-15E cannot accommodate JASSMs on its conformal fuel tank CFT weapon stations, since the container from which the missile is loaded onto the jet won't fit under the F-15E without hitting the main landing gear. Lieutenant Colonel Mike Benitez, the 53rd Wing Director of Staff, said, "No one told us to do this. We saw the need and the opportunity, so we executed." This infectious attitude drove every unit or office we coordinated with. Everyone wanted to see if we could do it, and no one ever pushed back and asked for a requirement or a formal higher headquarters tasking. Benitez added further, "This is a squadron innovation effort with operational and strategic implications." Project Strike Rodeo is all about creating options for combatant commanders, which ultimately can be used to create multiple dilemmas for the adversary. The McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle is an American, twin-engine, all-weather tactical fighter aircraft designed by McDonnell Douglas, now part of Boeing. The Eagle first flew in July 1972 and entered service in 1976. It's among the most successful modern fighters, with over 100 victories and no losses in aerial combat, with the majority of the kills by the Israeli Air Force. The F-15 was originally envisioned as a pure air superiority aircraft. Its platform included a secondary ground attack capability. The aircraft design proved flexible enough that an improved all-weather strike derivative, the F-15E Strike Eagle, was later developed, entering service in 1989, and has been exported to several nations. Serial production of the F-15 is largely driven by foreign sales in recent years. This has enabled the integration of new technology and weapons and keeps the workforce, as well as the manufacturing facilities, fresh. The AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile is a stealthy and highly precise surface-skimming cruise missile with a range of 230 miles or 370 kilometers. It uses an inertial and GPS navigation system. A data link allows the missile to transmit its location and status during flight, enabling improved bomb damage assessment. AGM-158B JASSM-ER is the extended range variant of AGM-158 JASSM. It has a range of 925 plus kilometers or 575 plus miles. AGM-158C is developed as an anti-ship variant and is named LRASM by the U.S. Navy. The missile is subsonic, but since it's LO, low observable, the enemy warship will not see it coming till it's very close. The missile uses an inertial and jam-resistant GPS navigation system for the initial phase of the journey. A two-way data link is present for mid-course guidance, and a radio frequency and infrared sensor is activated in the terminal phase. LRASM also deploys electronic counter-countermeasures, ECCM, to overcome the enemy's countermeasures. The missile can be deployed in swarm mode, which will enable it to saturate enemy defenses. In a contested environment, F-15E Strike Eagle could hit enemy assets without getting inside the rival's engagement envelope using JASSM. This is important since near-peer rivals of the US, like Russia, is investing heavily in air defense systems. S-300 and S-400, designed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau, are equipped with long-range radar and missiles to take out fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles. The systems have been sold to China, which clearly demonstrates the proliferation of sophisticated air defense systems. Even second-tier powers like Iran have developed indigenous air defense systems that have decent capabilities. For example, Iran has deployed Khordad 15. Khordad 15 is a mobile air defense system that's claimed to be indigenously developed by Iran. Speaking at the unveiling ceremony, Brigadier General Amir Hatami had said that the system is capable of detecting fighter jets and combat drones from 150 kilometers or 93 miles away and tracking them within a range of 120 kilometers or 75 miles. Keeping these in mind, F-15E Strike Eagle, loaded with an enhanced quantity of JASSMs, could be a game changer.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.